salt air and the rust on your door. I never needed anything more, or whispers of are you sure. Never have I ever.
Hi, I'll just give you a view of all the yarn I will talk about today. Welcome to my video podcast, Knit Dreams, Wool and Love. Today's episode is about the Invercargill shawl. I will tell you and I'll talk about how it appeared and my experiences in Invercargill, New Zealand. And I will talk about yarn alternatives, the yarn it's made of and the yarn alternatives. And I will talk a bit about knitting techniques, but not much because it's not a difficult shawl to make. Well, before I get started, I will make a short, a short introduction about myself. If some new people is coming into my podcast, I hope so. My name is Trine. I'm a Danish woman living in Denmark. I'm a knitting designer. I'm a writer. I'm a lecturer. I do lectures about my knitting trips to New Zealand and Ireland. And hopefully I'm in the future will travel and do more knitting trips and then more books and more lectures. That's my dream. And and the lectures is, yeah, about my knitting and all my experiences, but definitely also about living my dream, though I'm 50 plus. Then I'm a teacher, I'm a coach, I'm a mom, I'm a daughter, a sister, to you guys who have not been into my podcast before, there are some previous episodes you can watch. If you subscribe, it's easy to find me and it will help me in my dreams, and it will be easier for me to travel on and to tell more stories. So that would be a great help to me if you subscribe to my video podcast. My video podcast is made like the episodes have names and not numbers, because then it's easy, I think, to find them. And that's because each episode is about one of my designs. All my designs, I think almost all of them, they are made out in the world, and they contain stories and adventure, because they appeared out there somewhere. And that's how I work as a knitting designer, because I do not, I'm not hooked up on one yarn company. Because I'm traveling around, then I have all my designs are, you know, in different yarn qualities from different yarn companies, and that's why I try to find yarn alternatives, so it's as easy as possible to find yarn for the design the way where you are in the world. Let's get started. I don't think there was more. No, then I will, if I remember, I will say that later. But well, let's get started. This is the Invercargill shawl. And yeah, as I've been, told you in previous episodes, I've been traveling in New Zealand a couple of times, many times, but two times with my knitting needles. And on my first trip, you can listen to that episode. It's called New Zealand #1. I went down on the South Island all by myself in a car. And I won't say a lot about that, because you can just go back to that episode if you get curious about that trip. But I went all the way down to Invercargill. And I think Invercargill is somehow a interesting town because it's the southernmost town in New Zealand, in New Zealand. And actually one of the most southernmost towns in the world. And when I came down there, I experienced Invercargill like an old western town. Like you came to this town and it was just one long street, like all the way through. And I could just look, you know, from the one end to the other. And it was quite silent. There wasn't, you know, many people and not many cars. And then the buildings, the type of buildings, the style is this colonial style I've talked about before, that you meet a lot in New Zealand. These wooden houses with a, I don't know how to explain that, but colonial style, I think, like when in a western town, with these, do you call it a deck or something, just outside the town, just a narrow deck with some roof on. It's like, it reminds me of a western movie. I think that was quite funny. So that was a special town, and I really felt that I was really far away in the world. So, but that was a good feeling. I stayed down there for 2 or 3 nights and stayed on a campsite. And one day I had this walk down in Invercargill city, town, whatever. Yeah. And then I found the knitting shop. It was in 2018, so I don't know if it's still there, but it was called Knit World, I think. And there are a lot of shops in New Zealand called Knit World. It's like a chain, somehow. But this small shop was really nice and full of lovely yarn. And the woman in the shop, she was lovely. She had this short hair, totally purple, like purple. I don't have some yarn in that color, but it was like, okay, hello. And then she was so welcoming and so sweet. And she called me love in every sentence. She was really, really a nice person. And then I found this lovely yarn. It's from a company called Naturally. And this yarn is called Amuri 8 Ply. But I actually don't think you can get this yarn anymore. Oh yeah, if they have some stash somewhere, if you Google the yarn. I just found some in a shop in Australia. But I don't think they produce it anymore. I can't find it in the website, so I don't know. But the yarn is 75% merino wool and 25% possum. And you can find yarn with possum as a lot of other qualities from other yarn companies. That's a yarn company called Sealana. They have really, really lovely yarns with possum in. So you can find a quality with wool and possum somewhere. So it doesn't have to be exactly this one. I will say more about that later. But this one, yeah, 75% merino wool and 25% possum. And if you who listen are from New Zealand, then you will, yeah, this, what I'm telling you now, you know that already. But to you who haven't been in New Zealand, then the possum is like a brush-tailed possum. It's a animal this size with a very, very soft fur. But there are too many in New Zealand. They are really bad for the environment, and they came from, by an accident, from Australia. And in New Zealand, there are no, now I struggle with the words, but there are no dangerous animals that can, so there is no threat to the possums, so they can just, there are too many possums, I think you know what I mean, yeah, and that's a problem. But then they have found out to use the fur from the possum to combine that with the merino wool, and that makes really, really a lovely yarn quality. So all the good stuff about the merino wool gets even better. The possum fur add like to the merino wool more like softness and more, it's even warmer and it's, yeah, softness and warmer, and it's very light. It doesn't, it's very, very light. So it's just such a lovely quality of yarn. And this green color, you can see like the fur is just like a shadow, a dark shadow over the yarn. It's quite beautiful. And back when I bought the yarn in that little shop in Invercargill, I got it cheap, or you know, reduced price. It was on sale. Yeah, it's that's called on sale. And that was because the color would not be made anymore. And I remember I thought, how do I do that? Because I wanted to make a book when I came home from New Zealand. And there were so many things to consider when you want to make a book and you haven't done that before. Things that I didn't in the beginning thought should be a problem. So, but I decided to buy the yarn because I know the yarn companies, though many yarn companies keep on producing a quality of yarn and have this color chart always, then it changes over time. So I thought, well, I'll buy the yarn anyway because I think it's so, so beautiful and I'm inspired. So, and that's how the book is going to be. It's going to be my experiences in New Zealand. So I bought the yarn, though I knew they wouldn't make it anymore. But that's why I will tell you about yarn alternatives, and there are some very good ones. Yes, and when I traveled in New Zealand, I bought loads of yarn, and I couldn't, I didn't have time to knit of all the yarn I've bought, you know, because I bought yarn all over the place. But before I left New Zealand on this trip, the last couple of days I was in, I stayed in Akaroa near Christchurch, and the first stitches for this, I cast them on and started the shawl in Akaroa in New Zealand. Yes, so I have some very good memories when I started up the shawl, because when I sat there in Akaroa, I had only a few days back left in New Zealand, and then I was going back to Denmark, so I could sit there and just think about all the things I had done, and that I was like, I was somehow amazed by what I've, realized I was capable of, you know, to travel alone around New Zealand and left side in a car all alone. It was just amazing. I had the most amazing trip, but you can hear more about that in the a previous episode. So, well, so that's the Invercargill shawl and where it appeared. A bit about the technique. It's just a, somehow it's an ordinary, you know, traditional triangled shawl made in rib. Knit 3, purl 2, and you start here in the at the neck. Do you call that the neck up here? And you cast on 7 stitches, and then on every right side row you increase 4 stitches in the beginning and the end, and on each side of the middle stitch. That's how that you can see the middle stitch here, and then you increase 4 stitches on each right side row. And then when you knit and get more stitches, you get to, you know, you just get them into the rib pattern continuously. Can you say that? I think so. Yes. So when you knit the shawl, it gets because it's rib, it likes to do like this. I have an example here, so it can look a bit funny and looks like that's where I have cast on the stitches. So it looks like that's down on the shawl, but it's not. So when you have finished the shawl, you have to wash the shawl and then put it on a towel and then open it up so you can stretch it, so the rib is not, you know, pulling it together, and then you get the right shape of the shawl. I do that with all my knitting, and I almost always knit, you know, of wool, and I put it in my machine. I do the machine wash on 30 degrees with a wool detergent, and then on a program in the machine that's for wool. And the spinning, I always do them low, like 600 or 800. I don't know what you call that, but yeah, not too much. Yes. Well, and then there are the tassels. You can do them if you want or don't. But if you want them, it's a good idea to take some yarn and make them before you start the shawl, so you know that you have enough yarn for the tassels. And also, when you knit the shawl, in the pattern it says like when you have 382 stitches, then you can cast off. But because I think you will knit the shawl in some other yarn, it's not the it might not be 382 stitches precisely, but always just see that you have enough yarn to cast off all the stitches. I think that's the cool thing about making a shawl, because you can, it's not important that it fits like when you do a sweater or a cardigan or even whatever. If you have some yarn or fall in love with some really lovely yarn there, which is like almost the same weight, then you can just make the shawl. If it's thinner, then you just make some more rows, and then you then you get a lovely shawl anyway. And this shawl is quite big, and you can use it like a real shawl warming you like this. And it's actually possible to because it's so big that you can tie it up on the back, and you have this, and you can still like use your arms. But I also often I've used this a lot like a scarf, like more like this, but it's quite big and doesn't have to be that big. So I really will recommend that you use the yarn you fall in love with. This one is really, really soft, and I think to use it like that, it's most comfortable and nice if it's really soft yarn. Well, I have some yarn alternatives I will show you. And as you might have noticed, I have two shawls here. I have this light green one. Show you the right side. The light green one with some, it is hand dyed yarn. So you can see there is some color things in it here. And then there is this beautiful red one here with a lot of speckles, or a lot of, no, not speckles, but it is also hand dyed. And these two shawls is made of the same type of yarn. It's actually one strand of the sock yarn from Hedgehog Fibers. It's 90% merino wool and 10% nylon. It's a lovely quality. And then one strand of Midnight Sol, it's called Midnight Sun. It's from a Danish yarn company called Kammerose. The Hedgehog Fibers is from Ireland. And Kammerose. It's a Danish company, and this quality is called Midnight Sun. This Midnight Sun, it's a bit like the kid silk that you can find so many places. This really lace weight yarn called kid silk. This is from Gepard, but it's quite expensive. And this one from Kammerose, Midnight Sun, it's not that expensive. And it's really lovely and a good quality, but it's baby alpaca. It's something called tinsel. I think it's a, well, how do you say, sustainable, or yeah, it doesn't matter, I can't explain it. And then it's a 10% merino wool. It's a really nice and soft, thin, you know, lace weight yarn. And when you use one strand of each quality, you can knit this shawl, and there are so many beautiful combinations. Yes, and then it gets really soft and lovely. This is 100 grams skeins with 400 meter. And if you want to knit a shawl in this size, you need two of this one, I don't have the two in the same color, but two skeins of the hedgehog fibers sock yarn and four balls of the Midnight Sun. Then you can get this shawl in this size. And I just love all the color combinations. This one is called Danube, and this beautiful green blue, and you can combine it with this light turquoise. It's really beautiful, and then it gets light, but you can also use this blue one, azure blue, I don't know what it's called, but then it will get more like, then this really nice and beautiful, more, it's hard to find the words, but you can see it's really a nice combination, a light beige, and this is a potluck, so it's a special one, a special edition, really beautiful. Then I have this blue, it's just examples, this pink, and you can combine it with a pink or this light, what it's called, coral, light pink, really beautiful too. And then I have these, it's more, maybe more like winter, these were like summer. This one is called Renaissance, and this is Bordeaux. Really beautiful, yeah. And this green one, I also love that a lot. Ferrum, this olive kind of green, and with a green one here. Really beautiful. So there are so many possibilities in these yarn qualities, but if you don't like these bright colors and all this speckled one, then you can make it in something more a nature look. BC Yarn have this Loch Lomond organic wool, looks like this. There are two green colors, not same green as my shawl from New Zealand, but yeah, this may be the light one, I don't know. But it's really beautiful. And this yarn had the speckles in. So it's, I just think it's really nice. But it's more like a nature look. It's more, it's not as freaky as the other ones. And then it actually fits the tension, the gauge. So it's the same, this is 50 grams is 150 meters, and that's the same as in this yarn. So, and the same needles. I knit on needles 5.5 millimeters, and when you knit these ones with the hedgehog sock yarn and the Midnight Sun, it's also on 5.5 needles. Yeah. Well, then I found some yarn in my stash that I want to show you. Because as I said, I think a shawl, you can knit it a shawl in whatever yarn you want to. Just that you think about what size of needles you use, it should fit to the yarn. And then if it's much thinner than this one in the pattern, you can just knit some more rows. I started up on this one. It's a very, very thin lace weight green one. It's from the Touch Yarns in New Zealand. And I don't remember, I think it's some mohair and some merino, but I don't have the tag anymore, but really beautiful. And then I had this from Gepard, it's also a Danish yarn company, a kit seat, a kit mohair and silk, a very lace weight one. And I knit these two strands together on a needle four millimeter. And then it looks like this. It's more like airy or something. Yeah. But then I didn't want to knit a green shawl because I have a green shawl. So I found some other in my stash. I have so much yarn. You don't believe it. Oh, but this is going to be so nice. I'm knitting this shawl on 4.5, I think. And maybe I should have done it on needles number 5. I don't know. It's okay. But it gets so lovely. It's really nice and soft. And this baby blue, is I just like that a lot. It's really beautiful. So, and it's the, up here is the neckline. And that's made of the cotton wool 3. It's an organic yarn. 50% cotton and 50% wool. It's from the Danish company called Gepard. And it has this, it's really light blue, baby blue, but with a white, it has this white thread in it. And this quality, I know that Gepard has a really, really lovely color card chart, whatever. There are a lot of beautiful colors. And a lot of them have this white thread in it. And I just like that a lot. It makes like some life in the yarn. It makes it it makes it live. And then I combine it with a strand of the Midnight Sun, as I mentioned before, this light blue one. And then I have a plan, because when I get the shawl big enough and before I cast off, I have a plan that I will use some of my leftovers. Yeah, I have some small ones here. Because then I will, instead of combine the cotton wool with the blue one that I've used all the way up in the shawl, I will combine it with a yellow one. So, show you that one thread of each with a yellow, and then I might make, I don't know, one or two rows, and then I will combine it with this one and maybe with this one, so I get like in the edge of the shawl, down this edge on the shawl here, it will be some narrow stripes where I put I keep on using my cotton wool, the blue one, but then I combine it with some other colors in the Midnight Sun, just to get a funny edge with some colors in. I think that could be quite nice. And that's how I think it's lovely and great fun to play with colors and what you have in your yarn stash leftovers to make these, make lovely shawls. Yes, I'll have a look at my notes. I think I've said it all. So that was the Immerkagel shawl. Ah, yeah, you can find the pattern. Oh, I forgot to say that. No, but you can find the pattern in my book. I've made this this book called Around the World with My Knitting Needles, and you can get it on saxo.com, and the pattern for Invercargill Shawl is in the book. But you can also buy the pattern on Ravelry, and you can also buy the pattern in my web shop. So it is easy to find. So enjoy. I would love if you share your result, if you knit the Invercargill Shawl on maybe Instagram and tag the Invercargill Shawl and maybe me. On Instagram, I'm called Trine Eger. I will link to my Instagram down under here. And to my Facebook site, it's called Design by Trine Eger Nielsen. It's a bit confusing, I know that, but that's how it is. So I'm sorry. But I will make links for all the yarn companies and my Instagram and the book and everything down under here, so you can find your way. And otherwise, you are really welcome to make a comment or ask any question. Then I'll try all that I can to answer any question you have. Thank you so much for watching this episode of Knit Dreams, Wool and Love. I hope you will be back, and I hope you will subscribe so you can stay with me and help me on my adventurous journey. See you around. Bye-bye.
Salt air and the rust on your door. I never needed anything more. Or whispers of "Are you sure?" Never have I ever before.